didn't say pay. My shop's kind of a pigsty, through no fault of my own, obviously. But I'm gonna go ahead and I got a Titan rack, a wall-mounted lumber rack, and what I want to do is take all the stuff and try to organize it and some of the metal over there. And what I want to do is take it over here and pull this old garage rail down and move this stuff out of the way. And I'd like to put it up here above the working area here. For the most part, I'll just pull stuff out when I use it, like the table saw. I don't use that against the wall because there's no room. I pull that out here and I go out the door with it. But I think I'm going to put it over here. Anyway, I'll give you guys a review of it. That's all underground over there mostly. So the house is built up, but I'll give you guys a review and we'll see if it holds the weight. It's supposed to hold, I think, 600 pounds. So I think I could do that and reclaim all that space over there. Like I said, it's just a waste of space, and it's been sitting here since I moved, and it's been accumulating and going and back and forth, and I don't know, it's gotta go. So let me get that thing put up. You just drill some holes in the wall. I'll use the hammer drill over there and just knock it out real quick. But let's take a look and see if we do it, because I'd like to put maybe a reloading bench over here, or maybe in the other room. I don't know. I'll figure it out later. But I gotta get the shop cleaned up, so let me get to that, and I'll just show you the review after I'm done, you know, on the wall, and then we'll see where we gotta go. If I can fit it over there, we'll see. I'll be back. Here it is, out of the box. There's not much to it. Where is it? Six shelf. I think each one is supposed to hold 100 pounds. That's how you get 600 pounds. Like I said, I'm gonna put it in the wall right here. I'm gonna put it up on the ceiling, and it should be good. I can't read all that. I ain't gonna blow. No, I guess I'll read it. But let's go over here. I'll just put it up against the ceiling like that. And you know, whatever that is. Legs cracked. Joy. Oh well. Maybe I'll put it over here. I won't actually go into it. Ooh, I guess it is cracked. Huh. Oh well. Oh well, so it's staggered, so anyway, I'll go ahead and put this up there, and it'll be pretty good. So let me just figure out the spacing, if there's a specific spacing or not, I don't know. But let me go ahead and get this done. Now they got that rod going up there, and we're gonna actually have to wire in our right light correctly, but let me get to that, and I'll be back after a while, after I get all done. Alright, I went ahead and put it up over here. This wall in the back, instead of the wall I was originally looking at. I didn't like the cracks in the wall, didn't want to stress it since it's part of the foundation. What I'm going to do with that is I'm just going to fill it up with concrete. I talked to several structural engineers, and they said just pour concrete down. He goes, a lot of times that's code even now for a lot of things. So the top of it's actually open. So I can just pour concrete. It'll take a while, probably about 4 bags for 2 columns, you know, and that'll strengthen the wall and everything else, and, you know, because the house is shifting, I guess, over all these years. But anyway, this is up. It'll support my weight. We won't say what that is, but it ain't 600 pounds. Now, let me get the anchors. Hold on. This is what they originally wanted to use. I'm not so sure this would work in concrete. In fact, I think this is for wood studs in the house, but I'm not going to do that. I went right ahead and got some Tapcons. These are the ones I used and put up that way. There's 6 of them in there. That'll hold more than those, I'm sure. So I may add more later, but I probably won't. But what I'm going to do over here is I'm just going to throw all this away. I'll keep the metal, the bed frame, because that's hard to steal. I'll cut the ends off the angle grinder, and then I'll put them all up here. But that's my plan, but I like it. I might get another one put underneath. Made sure it was tall enough up there where I could do that, which I might not. I don't know what I'm going to do. I just got to get room out here to work for my projects. But all this wood, some of it has like mold on the bottom.
It's just, I'm just gonna throw it all away. The heck with it. Get rid of it all. I don't want it. It's no good. Heck with it. Throw it out. Well, it's not that expensive anyway. See that? I had that up against the wall over there and stuff. It's got wet. Throw it out. But I'll keep the aluminum and the steel and the good wood. But other than that, no. But okay, so we got 8 foot over there. That's an 8 foot board up there. So there we go. That's it. I'm very, very pleased with this product. I'll put a link below. I think it's about $30 maybe. Almost say about it. Just, it gives me room stuff, so clean my shop up. Now we can get on to some good projects. And you know what I'm talking about. Some of the really good stuff I've been putting off forever. But it's like 1 in the morning. I gotta get to bed and get to work tomorrow, so I'm gonna call it a night. And like I said, probably this weekend or something, I'll throw this out and cut all that up or cut the ends off. Maybe not, I don't know, we'll see. It's a good corner brackets, I guess. Anyway, recycle what I can, but like I said, these stainless steel thresholds and stuff, I'm not gonna throw those away. But these wood, it's just junk, burned up, or not burned up, but not good. So. All right, it's NCP. Y'all have a great weekend. I don't know when I'll get this uploaded, but have a good one, guys. I'm out. I get to bed.